boy, kiddos, we're talking about Halo today. You read that right. And boy, I'm excited to dig into it. I love me some Halo. Man, I still remember when my cousin got an Xbox and he showed me Halo Combat Evolved. We played so much co-op and deathmatch together, it was a fun time for sure. Now, I will admit, I'm not a gigantic Halo fanatic that knows every little bit about all the Halo lore and played every single game, but I still like it. And I think very highly of the original Xbox game. Halo was one of the first FPS games I ever played. My very first being Medal of Honor Frontline, and man, the quality jump from that to Halo blew me away. Even when I was a little kid with my Xbox, I was like, this is it. This is the future of video games right here. And after playing all the way through such an excellent game once more, I finally feel like I can make my own video singing the praises of it. If you got a problem with that, you can stick a joystick up your ass. So Halo was a, oh come on, do I really have to do this? You know what Halo is. It's an awesome FPS game made by a wonderful company called Bungie. Bungie had already made a name for themselves with a super awesome FPS series called Marathon. A boomer shooter of the highest caliber. I'm not even joking or memeing about that. Marathon is fucking awesome. The graphics are awesome. The music is awesome. The gameplay is amazing. The maps are... okay, it has a few problems, but that's its own video. But it definitely belongs in the big boomer shooter hall of fame. And you know what's even more awesome? You can play it for free right now. All of the Marathon games are available for free, patched to work with Windows 10, gifted to us by Bungie themselves. So that'll give you something to play today. Now back to Halo. So Halo went through a few different phases before it became what we know it is. To start out with, it was a top-down game, and then it became a third-person shooter. And it used to be called Blam. In an alternate universe, a different version of you is playing Blam Infinite right now. And Bubsy became more popular than Sonic and Mario. That's a scary thought. What's even scarier was the game at one point was going to be a Mac game. In fact, Halo was being backed and shown off by Steve Jobs himself. Halo was almost a Mac exclusive. Holy shit. But we know how this story ends. Bungie ran out of money, so they struck a deal with Microsoft and got bought out. And Microsoft said, fuck that noise, you're making this game for our bitchin' new console, the Xbox. So Bungie had to drop everything they had built for the Mac platform and make their game for console. A new console that wasn't even out yet. No pressure. And the rest is history. Bungie made a banger of a game, and that game turned into a series that's still around to this day. And the Xbox became a huge success thanks to the huge sales and rave reviews of Halo. Master Chief is Microsoft's mascot. Halo is on cans of Pringles and Mountain Dew. There are Halo-branded condoms. Cover your jackal before you wackle. So that brings us to me and now. Do I think the original Halo is still as good and amazing as it felt all those years ago? Or has it not aged as gracefully as its elders before it, like the boomer shooters of old? Not that I'm calling it a boomer shooter. I honestly think Halo is when boomer shooters died. That was the birth of the modern day shooter, and wrote the groundwork on how FPS games were to be made for years to come. You know, until Dusk came along and said, hey, we can still make shooters the old way. But enough stalling. It's time to get down to it and play one of the most influential games of the early 2000s. This is Halo. Now, when you start it up, the title screen greets us with that classic Martin O'Donnell theme that we all know so well at this point. April Fools, you sons of bitches! We're playing the Atari Halo! Did you think for 1 second that Halo was the kind of thing I do on this channel? Hell no, this is peak Working Man game. Now I know what you're thinking, somebody put Halo on the Atari? They damn sure did. A man by the name of Ed Fries used to be the head of Microsoft Game Studios back in 2000, and he was the key person instrumental in bringing Halo to Microsoft. After reading a book about programming for the 2600, he decided to make his own game. At first, he just made a sprite of Master Chief, but people encouraged him to keep going and make a full game, and he did. The game was shown at the Classic Games Expo in 2010, where it was a smash hit and cartridges of it were being sold. The publisher, Atari Age, re-released it in 2013, and you can buy it as a game cartridge with a box and manual now. There's even a copy of this game at the Smithsonian Art Museum. Take that, From Software. You got a game in the Smithsonian? I don't think so. Back to the game. It's kind of similar to two other Atari games, Adventure and Berserk. Speaking of Berserk, I was surprised to find out the anime Berserk has nothing to do with the Atari game, which made me not interested in it whatsoever. So the first thing you want to do is pick up the gun. We'll just assume that's the Magnum. Also, I love that Master Chief looks like he's wearing a green and black striped shirt. Hey, I know what that is. That's a grunt. That's the guy that goes, "Wow!" So when you shoot something, the bullet keeps going until it hits something or it hits the wall. And you can only shoot one bullet at a time, which makes it kind of aggravating when you miss. Master Chief can only take one hit before he dies, but if you pick up a shield, he can take two hits. The enemies kind of have an unfair advantage in that they can shoot wherever they want to, and you can only shoot left and right. What, you thought you could shoot up and down? That's silly. Next, you're gonna tell me you think you get a sniper rifle in this game, and that you get to drive a warthog with a fucking machine gun on the back, mowing down little 8-bit grunts. What kind of game do you think this is? This is Atari, baby! You should be lucky you get to move 8 directions! You got a joystick and one button. You don't even get to pause! Pause this dick! So we're in the vaporwave world right now, and we find ourselves with a hall full of enemies in like rows of three. You shoot one in the front, and all three go down. The main thing you gotta worry about in this game is the enemies that have fast bullets. These little gray guys, they ain't nothing. It's the red enemies you wanna look out for. They've got really fast bullets. Your main objective in the game is to get to the goal, and you gotta pick up keys to open doors along the way. And you'll find upgrades for your gun and for your feet as well. I don't have to worry about that. I don't wear shoes. What are you laughing about? I think he was laughing at my feet, man. Shut the hell up. You're supposed to be in the corner. Now get back over there. Fine, jeez. So you got discarded too, huh? It's a temporary thing. He'll come back around. Yeah, you keep thinking that. So after you get the upgraded gun, the game gets a little bit easier. You also notice something about the enemies. When you enter the screen, they take a moment before they do anything. They kind of stand there for a little while. You can use that to your advantage to get the drop on them. There's also some rooms that have ice physics. Ooh, ice physics, my favorite. You know what else is my favorite? Enemies that are twice as big as they normally are and are stretched out like I stretched the video out. Even I quit doing that. People who do this to 4x3 games should be shot. Not killed, shot. That way they have a little injury to remember the next time they try to stretch a 4x3 game. Later on, you get these speed boots that give you speed boots. Speed boots that give you a speed boost. Oh my god, that was the hardest shit to say in the world. You get boots that make you run faster. There, that was easier. Anyway, the boots make life a little easier for you because now it's easier to dodge the bullets, especially from these turret things. You can't kill the turrets either, so you just have to run past them, which sometimes is easier said than done. At this point, the game starts spawning nothing but turrets and red dudes that have extremely fast bullets. At this part, instead of just shooting everything, I just run. I just run for my fucking life, which doesn't work all the time. Game over, gotta start the whole thing over again. I would be mad, but the game is really short. In fact, I was almost done. So I had to do everything all over again, but this time I've got the flow down. I know what I'm gonna do now. My strategy is I'm trying to run through the whole level like I'm trying to speed run the shit. And it works for the most part. I just imagine Halo. I just called Master Chief Halo. Yeah, I just imagine Master Halo has gotta take a wicked shit and he's gotta get to that turlet on time. Or else there's gonna be one hell of a puddle of mud in the Mississippi River. Dude, what if you shit yourself wearing power armor? How long would it take to get the stuff off? And if you did it in the middle of a firefight, well, I guess you'd have to wait. Oh man, it's final boss time. It's a moose wearing a hard hat on a spaceship. And boy, is he tough. He's real fast, shoots 3 shots at a time, and he takes 3 hits to kill. But you can kill him, and your reward is a seizure. And that is Halo 2600. That's it. That's the whole game. Well, actually, there's a second difficulty mode you can play after defeating the final boss, but it's so damn difficult, it's not even possible to beat, I don't think. Because now you walk as slow as molasses. I got killed by the first enemy in the game, damn it. So that's Atari Halo. Wow, we're actually done faster than we normally are in these videos. We got lots of time left, honestly. I tell you what, let's review some more games. I've got other games that I'll never make a separate review on because they're so short, and I can't find a reason to bring them up in a bigger review, and I really want to make a review on them. So, we're gonna do that now. Happy April Fool's Day, everybody. This is the April Fool's Special. Our next game is going to be an Intellivision game, and it's a game that gives me a whole lot of joy just because of the name.
Mattel Electronics presents Space Con- Mattel Electronics
Shut up! So this is Space Cunt. Now you may be asking yourself, did Mattel actually make a game called Space Cunt? Well, actually, they kinda did! Space Cunt was made by some Intellivision programmers at Mattel as an inside joke between the developers. It is technically a ROM hack of a game called Astro Smash. The Intellivoice voice samples come from the games Space Spartans and Tron Solar Sailor. In Tron Solar Sailor, one of the enemies says, "I can't allow this," but because of the way the Intellivoice works, it sounds like it says cunt.
I can't allow it.
And as you'll notice, they made the main enemy in Space Cunt the enemy that says cunt in Tron. Shit, I probably said cunt so many times in this review that I'm gonna get demonetized, so if you would, please check out my Patreon. I'd appreciate it. So that's about all there is to Space... you know what. It was just a funny little inside joke game, but because it was made by Mattel developers while they were still Mattel developers, technically, this is a Mattel game. Kind of like Halo 2600 is almost a real Halo game, seeing how it was made by a Microsoft employee. But I've got one more game for us before we close out today. BMX Ninja. Guys, Ryu from Ninja Gaiden's pretty damn cool, but he's no BMX Ninja. So BMX Ninja is on the ZX Spectrum. It was also on the Commodore 64 and I think the Amstrad. Wow, there's a computer I haven't reviewed yet. Maybe I will one day. The game was made by Alternative Software, a company that mostly dealt with, well, budget games. They're apparently still around and still publish games to this day. Apparently the last game they put out was in 2020 called The Copper Canyon Dixie Dash. If it doesn't have Dixie in it, I'm not interested. So what do you do in BMX Ninja? I'm not sure? I have a theory that your bike is loaded to the gills with C4 because as soon as the other bike touches it, you explode. I've never known a bicycle to explode before. What are they painting it with, nitroglycerin? So you can like spin the bicycle and you can like bunny hop and a few other things, I think. I did kill the other biker a couple of times though. One time a skateboard man showed up and he must have triggered my detonator because I immediately blew up when he went past me. What is it about bicycles blowing up? Are we trying to teach our kids to be scared of bikes? It's like the Christmas Story thing about you'll shoot your eye out. You'll blow yourself up. Have you noticed something missing in this game? Something that's right there in the title, but we don't see a single one? There's no ninjas. There's not one single ninja. There is zero ninja. This shouldn't even be called BMX Ninja. This should be called BMX Blow Yourself the Fuck Up, I guess. This game is iconically bad. Most British gamers from back in the day remember this game very well and know it to be horrible. In fact, Ashens did a review of this game once, so I'm basically desecrating a corpse that's already been desecrated once. And after this video, I think BMX Ninja can finally take a very long dirt nap. I tell you what, we still got time. You want one more? You want to do one more? Let's do one more. Ninja Scooter Simulator! Look at him! Just when you thought they couldn't make a simulator for anything else. Made by Silverbird, who was owned by Firebird Games, who I've made fun of before because of their name. Man, we need a Camaro Games. So again, Ninja Scooter Simulator also has no ninjas. Instead, you get this kid with sunglasses and a hat. This game reminds me a lot of Excitebike. You just go from left to right, avoid the obstacles, and get to the goal before the time limit. As you can see, I'm having a hard time at it, but the more I played it, the better I started to get at it. You got ramps and speed boosts. There's that hard to say word again. And oh look, I won! And like any good game, it gives you more shit you gotta look out for the more rounds you go through. Suddenly I got attacked by Speed Buggy. Y'all might be too young to know Speed Buggy. And then I got jump scared by Bones.
Rattly Bones!
That wasn't the only bones either, I had skulls too. I want your skulls. Danzig, don't sue me. And finally, to round it all off, I started getting chased by Scotland Yard. Oi, what's all this then? Got us a ninja on a scooter, we do? Also, guys, apparently don't forget to hate the hype. What hype? The hype of what? There's gotta be hype about something before you can hate it. And before you hate the hype about something, you need to see if the thing you're supposed to hate is actually pretty good or not. Then if you don't like it, then you can hate the hype. Don't hate something just because it's popular. For example, I don't hate Fortnite. I've got nothing against it. In fact, what little bit I played of it was kind of fun. And I might play it again just so I can get the furry skins. Because I'm a fucking degenerate. You know, I played this game for almost half an hour because I was actually enjoying it. I kinda like this game. It's kinda easy and it controls well enough. Yeah, it's not bad. I can't believe I found a ZX Spectrum game I actually like. Now, if we could only find a modern AAA game I'd actually give a fuck about. And that's gonna be the April Fool's video, children. I hope y'all had fun. I hope y'all not too sore that I'm not actually reviewing Halo. But I was serious about Marathon. Marathon's great. So what have I got lined up for next time for a real video? I don't know. I've got a few things lined up. I just gotta decide which one I wanna do. I kinda wanna explore 3DO again. Not the console, the company. There's still some Army Man games that I haven't played. There's also that weird spin-off game on the PS2, and there's also their other series they had. But there's also this visual novel that everybody's playing now that I'm thinking about checking out. It's called, like, Delay? Reverb? Something like that? Anyway, we'll figure it out in time. Well, boys, if you enjoyed the video, y'all know what to do. You don't need me to tell you. As usual, consider becoming a patron. I've got $1 and $5 tiers. $5 gets you in the Discord server, name on the board, and early access. We're thinking about running some new Patreon tiers, so let me know what you would like to see. Well, that's it for now. I'm Stuart K. Riley. Y'all have a good day. See y'all. Linus Tech Tips was an inside job.